Hi everyone, how are you guys tonight? You guys are live here on the Brush by Brandy Facebook and Instagram pages. My name is Brandy and I'm the owner and artist behind Brush by Brandy. And my husband is behind the camera. He's gonna help us answer questions for anyone who pops on.
You guys, I have a question. Can you not talk with an echo?
Oh, it is super echoey. It's super echoey. I hear it too. Should we open the door a little bit?
No.
My husband Sean is behind the camera to help answer questions. So we paint here live with you guys every Thursday evening at 9 p.m. Eastern, and we're actually not going to paint tonight. We're going to talk about something that's probably even more essential to painting, and that is how I care for my brushes. So I'm going to go through and show you guys everything from what I've got in my brush cleaning station, what do I use the most, how do I clean stubborn brushes, wax brushes. We're going to talk about all of that tonight. So you guys, if you have brush questions, let me know what those are. Let me know where you guys are watching from and how everyone's doing tonight. And yeah, we'll go ahead and get started.
So, I'm watching from the garage and I'm doing okay.
I'm glad to hear it.
Hi, my name is Sean.
I first want to say that I am, my brush cleaning station doesn't normally look like this. I've actually taken the entire cabinet apart because I wanted to show the process of how I would refinish either, you know, what would be a bathroom vanity or a kitchen cabinet process. And so I'm doing it on my own cabinet. I can't paint the ones in my house because they're brand new cabinets.
Because that's what they look like?
Yeah, I would probably get murdered if I painted the cabinets in my own kitchen. So I'm going to do the process on this cabinet, and it's midway through the process. So that's where I am right now. Usually it doesn't look like this, and it's going to be really pretty when it's done. I'm actually going to use, I'll show you guys what that's for in a minute. I'm going to use a Wisol Winter Enamel, and the color I chose is called Metrocity. Sean gets that. It's called Metro City. But if you guys have kids and you've seen the movie
Megamind,
and there's a villain in there
named Megamind. And instead of Metro City, he calls it Metrocity.
Yeah. And so every time I see this name, I'm just going to say it Metrocity, and you guys have to get it.
I really like the industrial look that you got going on with the, let's just, the elephant in the room here, the nice water heater on the right.
Yeah, that's my water heater. We have
it's one. As big as an elephant.
Yeah, it's no secret, right? Okay. This is in my garage, and I'm super, super lucky we had it. We plumbed the garage with the intent that I could have a sink here. I chose this stainless steel countertop because it's got an integrated sink in it. Stainless counter, stainless backsplash. It's really, really easy to clean.
Oh, and another reason you picked it. It was cheap on Craigslist.
Yeah, it was. I found it on Craigslist and I was like, okay, that would be so perfect. And then we just found a vanity that fit underneath it, and it really has worked out really well. So this is my station, and let me show you guys some of the stuff that I've got out here that I use the most, okay? And then we'll get into cleaning some brushes. So I've got basics. I've got Dawn dish soap. I've got some paintbrush cleaning soap. This is Bad Ace brush soap from Wise Owl. I've got regular hand soap. That's just for me.
For my sensitive hands.
This is Dawn dish soap, but this is their foaming kind. It's a foaming pump for it, and I just mix some of this when I need to refill this. So I do like to have the foaming kind. I've got nail brushes, because I do not like when my hands are dirty, so I use nail brushes. I've got a couple of those. I use this guy when I want to clean my sink and my backsplash if I get any splashes up on there. So those are just for cleaning my sink area.
Or brushing my teeth.
I've got a bar soap, and I'll show you what I use that for. Just some old sponges, because sometimes you need old dirty sponges. I get these little containers at the Dollar Tree. These are Betty Crocker ones. And just any little container, I use them for either soaking, for mixing paint in, for anything like that. This one's holding my sprayer parts in it right now. This is a dish for spatulas, brushes. This is a guy I like to use, and I'll pull out one of these guys too. So different kinds of wire brushes. I've got some spatulas for if I'm cleaning out a container, because sometimes I'll save containers for mixing in and storing in. So I'll use a spatula to scrape the container out. So I keep a couple of those over here. So that's just that kind of stuff. Okay, so that's kind of everything I've got out here. And then what I have is I've got this little guy here. This is a baby bottle drying rack. And this one actually is for my own children. But you can find these at the thrift stores. They used to sell them at Target. And this comes out actually need to clean mine, but yeah, I totally do. But what I use this for is for drying brushes that can't be hung. So that's that guy. And then I've got these hooks over here. And I use these for hanging brushes whenever I can hang them. Some brushes don't have the ability to be hung. One example is these guys here. These are the Klingon S50 brushes, do not have a loop on the back. And so these are ones I have to stand to dry versus hanging to dry. But the friction of these needles in the bottle drying rack keeps the pressure from resting on the tips of the bristles, which can distort your brush and cause your bristles to get messed up. So it kind of suspends them in there.
I really like the cleaning brush.
Yeah. Okay, so you guys want to clean some brushes. I'm going to start with what's the most basic brush that you would clean. What's my, you know, most usual everyday process, and that is I've just got a brush that I've been painting with. It's pretty fresh paint, not super hard. I'm just going to dip this in some paint. I'm going to load this brush. This makes me cry because I feel like I'm wasting paint. But I'm going to go ahead and load this brush up. I'm going to work it into the bristles a little bit. So this would be just a regular daily process from a brush that I'm cleaning, that I've been painting with. The paint is pretty fresh. It's not crusty or anything. What would be my process for that? And I'll give you the gist of it. What I usually use the most of is this guy here, which is it's a makeup cleaning mitt. It's a silicone mitt that's used for cleaning makeup brushes, but I use it for cleaning my paint brushes. So
is there anything up here that was made to clean paint brushes?
Yeah, there is some
stuff. You straight up MacGyvered everything.
You guys will see as we go what's kind of repurposed and what's actually made for cleaning brushes. So I use that a lot. I use this a lot, which is a brush comb. And there's all different types of these in the hardware store. I like this one the most. This is a 5-in-1 tool. You can also clean rollers with it. With this side, you can scrape over the top of a roller and kind of squeeze it out. But I use this brush comb quite a bit. And then I use a wire brush a lot. This is a larger one, and these are smaller ones. These are actually available in the paintbrush section of your hardware store. So
I just want to throw a shout out to all the newbies.
Hey, guys.
Let us know if your friends knocked on your door and pulled you on camera.
If they did, then they earned their money that we're paying them. This is another type of a silicone brush cleaner for makeup brushes. These you can get at any sort of like drugstore that carries makeup brushes, whether it's this kind or this. They're on Amazon. You know, your local CVS or Target will have those. So these are really nice to have. I like the mitt kind better. I don't care for this one. It's got a suction cup on the back so you can stick it in your sink. It's supposed to look cool. It doesn't work though. So that's another alternative, but I like this kind better. So for my everyday brushes, what I use most of is water. I usually don't use a whole lot of soap in my brushes if I don't have to. So I'll run it under the sink and I work out as much of it as I can. Okay. And then sometimes you're left with a little bit of the paint that gets a little higher up in the bristles like this. I'll show you guys up close. You got some paint still in the bristles. This is just fresh paint. We're gonna do a stubborn one too. But this one's
back
just pretty fresh.
You're fine.
So for that last bit of paint, I get as much out as I can just using my hand and some water. If I need to, I can use my brush comb and let that brush get in. I do not hold my brushes under the water like this. I'm going to do it right now to show you guys. Because that forces the water to run up into the metal part. There's glue in here that's holding your bristles in. And by leaving that saturated, you can cause that to weaken over time. So I wash my bristles with them either facing down or even level, but try to not force that water up into the bristles of your brush.
I wasn't able to catch the name, I apologize, but over on Instagram, someone had mentioned a while back when you showed that makeup tray that you're using, it was game changer.
Oh, it totally is. They're super good to have, I'm telling you. So that's a super basic process. That one didn't take a lot. It didn't have stubborn paint on it. That's most of my brushes are just water. You know, I might comb them out a little bit. I might work them into the silicone mitt a little bit. That's a super easy one.
Yes, very true. You can actually put this around your hand there.
Yeah, I still feel like this having the raised edges on it kind of holds the soap in better. Whereas this...
Especially when bristles start...
Yeah, you guys will see in a minute when I actually have to do a more stubborn brush that I use soap on. This one doesn't hold the soap at all. So it just kind of all washes off. So what I did with my Klingon brushes have a hole in the end of them, and I like to hang my brushes. So they've got this hole in the handle. So I just bought this leather cording at my local craft store. It's in the jewelry making section, and it's just thin leather cording. And for my Klingon brushes, I cut a piece of leather cording and I just knotted it. And this allows me to hang them up on these hooks over here.
Where's the lace? Have you got the leather?
Yeah, no, sorry. Just no? Leather. You don't want the lace one. Yeah. No, we're rugged around here. Okay, so this was really hard for me. Sean even commented, he's like, did you know you have brushes sitting out on your cleaning station? I put paint on this earlier and I let the paint dry in there, which is not something I ever like to do. If I need to walk away from my brush, I'll either put it in the refrigerator in a Ziploc baggie. I'll even set it just in a little bit of water. If I gotta run, you know, I'd rather it sit in water, you know, just a tiny bit, not up to the metal. But I actually let this sit out on purpose so that we could clean a stubborn brush together. So this is really painful for me to see right now. It's actually crusty. So you guys can see that paint is pretty dry. It's been out for a few hours. It's crusted over. So what would I do for this? Again, I'm going to start with water. And I'm going to get as much of it out as I can with water. Chalky style paints have a level of reactivation because they're water-based paints. So when you introduce water again, it's going to soften that paint. Okay, so I can get a lot of this out using just water and working the water in with my hand, kind of pulling that paint out, and it does pretty well. So one thing I like to do is I keep a bar of soap on my counter, and I don't have a particular favorite. They're usually pretty cheap. This is one option. This is Fell's Naphtha, which is a laundry soap. This is like $2 at Walmart. It's super inexpensive. People use it for making homemade laundry soap.
Why do I picture like a washboard?
Yeah, it is. It's like that. Lava soap I like too. Lava soap has a little bit of a built-in abrasive. It's good for your hands. It's got a pumice inside of it. So lava soap is another one, but whatever it is, I just have I'll have a bar soap here, and I take my brush and I'll introduce a little bit of that bar soap onto it.
Well, Cheyenne, that's why I'm actually enjoying this. And I'm not cleaning brushes.
Then with a little bit of water, I'm going to take, and I'm focusing on the areas of my brush that have the paint kind of, see how it gets more crusted up in here. I find lighter colors are harder to clean out of my brushes than darker colors. So I'll kind of scrub this into the silicone. It's got little teeth on the mitt. Now this wasn't left out like overnight. You know, it's not one of those brushes that you have to let sit for 2 days while it soaks because it's really crusty. Primer is another one. Primer is really hard on your brushes. So I usually try to have a brush that's dedicated to primer. Because if you try to put it in and out of your brush flow, that primer brush will be a little more beat up than other ones. So then when you try to go do clear coat with it, that brush has been, you know, it's going to be harder to use as a nice brush later. So try to dedicate, if you can, if you have the ability, a nice brush that you use just for primer, because those primer's always really hard on your brushes. So I've still got a little bit of that hard, stubborn paint kind of stuck up here in my bristles. And so this is where I'll introduce the wire brush. So this is one, this is from Pretty Boy, who makes a brush soap, and I do like their brush soap. And I like the size of this brush too. And I'm just gonna sort of scrub, I'm gonna comb at my brush hair. And I'll flip it to the side, and I'll flip it again. And I kind of can spread out the bristles if I got paint inside, you know, in deeper. That was more on the surface of the outside. These are smaller guys, and this is the same concept of just using a smaller wire brush. They do tend to get beat up over time, but they're super cheap, so I just replace them. I'll even use it like this because it still serves its purpose. Okay, and once I've got that out of those deeper parts, I will rinse it out. That wasn't too bad at all. Okay, let's talk about a brush that you've had sitting out. You left it out. It's been probably, I don't know, days at least. And it's pretty stubborn. This one is not days. This one's hours, but still pretty stubborn. I'm going to still show you the process using this. So what would I do for these? They usually need to soak. If they're that bad and they've dried over 24 hours and you've accidentally left it out, you usually need to soak it a little bit. So when you soak your brush, you never want to soak it any higher than the metal. Okay, so make sure your water is setting below here. And I will put a little bit of brush soap in. So when my brushes are really stubborn, dirty, you're gonna need a good brush soap that you like. This is Bad Ace brush soap. This is from Wise Owl. And I do like this one. I'm gonna show you a couple more uses for this tonight too. But I'll soak it in just a little bit of the Bad Ace. And I'll even work a little bit into the bristles for it to soak in. Okay, and then I'll just let that soak for a little bit. These are for your really crusty brushes, and you're probably gonna need to let it soak a good 24 hours. When you come back, it's gonna have softened that paint up a little bit. It's still gonna be crusty. Whoops.
Can you please not knock stuff over?
I'll try to rinse out as much as I can, but you usually end up having to use the wire brush again, these really stubborn ones. And then you may need to soak it again, too. When I'm using the wire brush, I'm always brushing in the direction that the bristles go. Don't try to brush backwards. You're going to really mess your bristles up. And then you can comb that out. And I'm going to tell you something else about these Klingon brushes. They're really cool in that if you don't get your brush all the way clean, they will self-clean too. So what that means is if you take your brush and it looks most of the way clean, this looks pretty clean. I don't see any paint in there. You know, I would call this a clean brush, but it always surprises me.
Got lens.
That's right.
Camera lens.
Sorry, guys. If you let this soak, I'm going to let this soak for a minute. Let's try this one too. Which one did we just do? Last one. If you let these soak for a few minutes in the water, and I've seen this on slow motion video, but it continues to leach paint out of those bristles, sometimes that you can't even see, and it can be paint that you got up here under the metal and you didn't quite get it out. So if you have really stubborn brushes, let them soak in just a little bit of water on just those tips, and we'll come back and I'll check this water, but it always surprises me because it does. It continues to leach paint out of those bristles even over time. Another tip is sometimes your brushes, when you've used them a whole bunch, they just need like a spa day. Like I would say probably like once a month, I'll do this with my brushes. And that is I take a little bit of water and a little bit of fabric softener. Now I don't use this for cleaning. This is more of a conditioning. Some people use hair conditioner too. And I'll just put a little bit of fabric softener in here. I'm gonna mix this into my water and I'm just gonna let my bristles soak. And this is like, it's like they're in the hot tub, you know? And they come out super soft. So this would just be for that deep conditioning, just for softening up your bristles after they've had a lot of use. Like it's like a good job to your brushes, telling them, yeah, you had a good month. Here's your monthly bonus.
It's like a what? It's like a hot tub?
Yeah, it's a hot tub. It's a day at the spa for your brushes. So just soak in some hair conditioner, some fabric softener, and it makes your bristles super, super soft. So that's another option there. So the Bad Ace brush soap also works with makeup brushes. So this is one of my makeup brushes, just a little kabuki brush.
Huh?
That's really what it's called. Oh. So I've got another brush mitt here. This is one I don't use for paint brushes, so I'm not gonna give myself like a skin rash by sharing the mitt. But I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna work this one, and we'll clean a makeup brush with it too. So you can see I'm getting some makeup out of it. I'll show you guys on here. It's getting some makeup out. You can see the pink. Okay, so this one does have some makeup in it, and I'm gonna clean it as much as I can, get most of that superficial stuff off. Most makeups have, you know, are more of an oily consistency, but this will clean like foundation brushes. So I'll put a little bit of my Bad Ace brush soap on there. The other thing I like about Bad Ace is it comes in a bunch of different scents. This is lemon verbena scent. That tends to be my favorite. Bourbon vanilla is another one that's really popular.
Yeah, make sure you get all that superficial stuff off. Nobody likes superficial stuff, right?
Yeah, superficial, like my makeup. All right, so I did one squeeze, and then I'm rinsing it out. And I'm going to go ahead and do another little bit of my brush soap and work that in again. Until I'm going to do this until my water runs clear. Okay, let's see how close I got it. So now I'm going to rinse that brush soap out. I can already feel that it's much softer. Okay, and my water's not turning brown from that makeup brush. This is actually a brush that I use most every day. Well, that's a lie because I don't even wear makeup that often. But when I do wear makeup, I use this brush. So I'm going to put another bit on here just so we can see how much makeup is left in the brush.
I was going to say, I've never seen your karaoke brush.
Kabuki? You guys, tell Sean that a kabuki brush is a thing.
This is just going to get awkward.
Okay, so that's cleaning my makeup brush. Just a little bit of that Bad Ace brush soap, and it smells super good. So you can choose a smell. Those are the scents of the Wise Owl Furniture Salve and Furniture Tonic. You can get in the brush soap too. So you can kind of choose, like, if you have a favorite scent, and you can get that in your brush soap too. Okay, and then I'm going to squeeze out the water on this guy. I shake it out.
Thanks, Michelle.
And then here's where I'll show you that I just suspend brushes like this that don't have a holder on them in my brush rack like that. And all the water drains out. It's got a tray down here. And so I just wash that periodically. Okay, let's see. I clean these pretty good. I don't have a lot of paint coming out of them. I kind of wanted to show you guys that. And this guy's just enjoying his spa day over here. So if I leave these soaking in a little bit of fabric softener, I will just come back every once in a while and stir that water again, because the fabric softener can tend to separate a little bit in the water. All right, do you guys want to do a wax brush? Wax brushes are harder to clean than your regular paint brushes. So I've got a couple different wax brushes here. We'll do a couple of these. These are more stubborn. This is oil-based wax on here. This is an Annie Sloan brush that's got Annie Sloan wax in it. All right, so I'm going to show you, if I just try with just water, I don't get a whole lot of action. There's not a lot's going to come off of there. So this is what I like Dawn dish soap for. I'm going to squeeze some Dawn out. That was kind of way too much. And I'm going to work this into the brush on my brush mitt.
Wax on, wax off.
This pump of Dawn dish soap I get at Sam's Club.
The 55-gallon drum over here in the corner.
It's super functional.
Pay no attention to the jug.
I would say that whole drum was like, it's like $7 or something.
What?
It's super cheap.
Yeah. I was thinking like $3. That's way too much.
Oh, it's too much. I'll return it. What's our return policy? It's not like Costco. Shout out to Fireball June. All right, so I work it in. You know, I'm going to let this my soap get really nice and dirty. And I just use my fingers to kind of massage the bristles into the teeth of my brush mitt. All right, and then I'm going to check progress on it. And I'll rinse my mitt off, and I'm going to rinse my brush out. It already looks 10 times better. I don't wash my wax brushes after every use. I'm going to use the brush comb just to get some of the soap from outside of the center bristles. So I just kind of comb it out and let the water touch all the different areas. Because I remember, I don't want to go like this. So this helps the water to get into the center of those bristles too.
So really quick, not paint or not brush related, Kelly has a question about cherub paper.
Yeah.
Where did you get your cherub paper?
Okay, so that cherub paper is a gift wrap from society6.com. Society6 does custom papers. It's a rabbit hole. They have tens of thousands of designs. And it comes in sheets, 24 by 36 sheets. It's not a continuous roll. But you can get, if you're looking for a really custom design on a paper, man,
promise, Kelly, wasn't going to forget about you.
They have the most random papers. Some of them are, you know, might make your jaw drop a little, because pretty much like you can submit a design, and so graphic artists submit some stuff, and some of them are a little more young and edgy, so some of the designs are like, whoa.
Where do you get the mitt that you have?
This is just a makeup cleaning, brush cleaning mitt for makeup. So it's in like your CVS, your drugstore, where they would have makeup brushes. They'll have some sort of mitt like this that you can use for, otherwise Amazon, you know, Ross, any of those types of stores. So already you can see, this is my second go around with the wax brush. And already you can see I'm using the Dawn dish soap. I use Dawn because Dawn cuts grease, right? And this is oil-based wax.
Hey, I've seen those commercials.
With the duck. Okay, so I do not clean my wax brushes after every use. That's only after every few uses. If I just want my wax brushes soft again, I'll just come in and clean them out of their wax.
Oh, Mary got one at Tuesday morning.
Oh, yeah, there you go.
Oh, yeah. Monday morning. Did you get one there?
So it's like that Ross Marshalls Tuesday morning. Okay, and then I'm going to squeeze the water out. This one has a hook or a loop on the back, so I can hang this one to dry. So I'll hang that guy there. All right, the Klingon S50 is that one that I told you about that doesn't have the loop on the back, so I would let these sit in here to dry. Klingon, I don't think they have them anymore, but they used to make buckets that would suspend your brush to where you could do all this stuff that I'm showing you. You can suspend it into water. Some people will take and use magnets. So let's see if I can explain this. They'll put a magnet on here, just a loose magnet, and then they'll put it on like a metal bucket and it will suspend your brush in water. Because it's really not good to rest your brush on its bristles in, you know, like how I'm soaking them here, to rest them on their bristles. So you can take a metal bucket and magnet it to the side of the bucket, and then you can just fill your bucket with water, and that's where you can continuously let your brushes clean themselves. Or if you want to do the soaking in the fabric softener or anything like that, that's always a good idea too, to use that metal. So that guy will dry there.
Mind blown.
Show you another wax one. This one's a little bit deeper in the brush. I think it's been longer since I cleaned this one, but same concept. Use the Dawn dish soap. Get it wet, work a little bit of water in there, and you can see right away, like that wax starts coming out. This is black wax. When it's clear, it's harder to see. You're not going to see the color coming out of it when it's a clear wax brush.
Wendy, that's where my mind went to.
What?
I just didn't want to create more work for myself. Putting holes in the handles for you.
Oh, yeah, I've thought about that too, but I'm super scared that I'll ruin them, and I love those brushes, so that's just me being timid to drill one out. And I have that little stand, so it works. All right, so I do one round, and that gets the majority of it out. Let me show you, this already looks a million times better.
Chip clips.
Oh, yeah. Clips. Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, most of this stuff I see people using for brush cleaning, like I said at the beginning, it's repurposed. Like, this is for makeup brushes. That's a baby bottle drying rack. You know, I'm using the leather cording. This here is from IKEA, and it's from their kitchen section. And I'm actually going to put up another one, a longer one across the top. You took that one away from me.
Yes. Sherry, that's a tongue twister. Dr. Bronzer sells suds. It cleans brushes like a charm, too.
Yeah, there's all different kinds of brush soaps, and I'm not going to tell you one's better than the other. I'm just showing you the stuff that I use, because I do have, like I do like the Bad Ace. I like this because I like the scent of it, and I like that I can use this on paint brushes and wax brushes too. So I like this one. It leaves my bristles nice and soft. I like, this is Pretty Boy brush soap.
I do have one recommendation over all of them. I really like when you clean the brushes.
Yeah. I like when you do too. So I like this one. I'll show you guys this one. We'll clean this other wax brush with it. All right, so I did a second round with my dish soap. Make sure you rinse it out really well, because that dish soap, one thing I'll say is it will leave your bristles a little crusty if you don't rinse it thoroughly. Okay, so I rinsed that out really well. I don't worry about brush or wax brushes being as clean as my paint brushes, because like I said, I let it build up in there. I actually like when my wax brushes have a little bit of wax in them already. So let me show you this other brush soap.
So that way they sail easier across the room when you throw them at me?
So Pretty Boy is a small company out of New Jersey, and they sent this to me, but I actually really like it. So I'll put a little bit of their brush soap on here. Very similar process. And this also works for paint and wax brushes. I like that theirs foams up really well. This one has a smaller handle on it, so it's a little harder. So you can see the first go around, I get quite a bit of that wax off on the mitt. And I usually do always two. The first one gets the majority out, and the second one's just like the rinse cycle. Rinse my mitt off. And then I'll use another little bit of my Pretty Boy brush soap on here. And this time around, I'm getting barely any of that black wax. So two rounds of cleaning, and I usually get my wax brushes pretty good. I don't clean them every time. I chose the ones that had black wax in it so you guys could actually see the wax coming out of it. And then this one has a tiny hole, but I don't think it'll fit my... Oh, it will. Okay. Okay, so the setup I have over here for hanging my brushes, I'll show you guys what that is. These are wire brushes, and I just ordered these off Amazon. And I use these for different things, like sometimes cleaning pieces if I need to get into detailed areas, cleaning my brushes. So that's just a set of those from Amazon. This is these hooks here, which are, like I said, are from IKEA, from their kitchen section. And it's got all kinds of things that you can hang from them. Like this is a little bamboo basket. And what this is used for is like if I have to wash a sponge out, I can set the sponge on there to dry. Sea sponges I put in there. If I wash my sanding blocks, I'll put that in these guys to dry. So I have this little basket here that I'll use for that different kind of stuff. I don't have
not the front on there.
My drawer faces on, so I gotta pull it from underneath. Okay, so this is from IKEA, and IKEA names everything really weird. So this is Fintorp.
Directions.
This is a Fintorp, is all these hooks. Yep. And I just bought like five of these.
It's Swedish for gotcha.
I don't know what a Fintorp is. And then they have bars in the same department. This is the longer bar that I plan to put up here. This is the actual Fintorp bar. And the hooks thread onto here like a towel bar, and then that'll hang up. And then this is just a different option for the bar. This one has double layers, and this one works really good for brushes. So I really like that system there. Let's see. I didn't get a whole lot out here because these weren't super dirty brushes. I had just filled them this afternoon, but my paint or my water is a little milky. So it did continue to leach some paint out of that brush even after we clean them. It always surprises me. Even the cleanest looking brushes, you'll be surprised that they'll continue to drip a little bit of, paint out even after you clean them. I will also flick water down into my sink. I try to not do it all over. And that just gets as much water out as I can, any that might have gotten up under into the metal, and then these are the guys that I hang up here. And I'm gonna empty this out because I don't really need to soak my brushes right now. But already I can see it smells really nice. This was the one that was in the fabric softener, and it's already just really soft. So that was just, and I usually will put more than one brush in there, so it'll, pick like five of them that are starting to look a little rough around the edges, and I'll let them soak together. They go hot tubbing together.
Hot tub.
And then hang them up to dry. So that's kind of everything I use for my brushes. I mean, most of it, like I said, is all repurposed. Lots of hand soap. I wash my hands like religiously. Trying to think what else. You guys have been pretty quiet tonight, no questions? I see all kinds of tricks and like I said earlier, this is just one way. This is just the stuff that I use every day for my brush cleaning. But there are different things and, you know, different ways to do it, different brush soaps out there. I really do like the Bad Ace though. Like my hands smell. They smell like lemon verbena now.
Darn, it's at her day job, but she's gonna pop in and say hello. How long do you leave your brushes in fabric softener?
24 hours maybe. But I mean, unless I walk away and I forget, if I don't paint for, you know, if they're in there 2 days, it's not gonna really harm anything. So I don't know.
Again, the trick is you just don't have it high up on the.
Yeah, but usually it's overnight. I'll just let them soak in there overnight. And you can reuse that fabric softener because, you know, let's say I filled this with 5 brushes, you know, and I let them soak for 24 hours. They're clean brushes. You're putting clean brushes in the fabric softener. It's just a conditioner. So after I soak these 5, I could come back and put another 5 in there to soak too. So you can keep reusing that same little dish of fabric softener. So there have been times when I'll soak some and I'll just leave the dish of fabric softener here. And as I get stubborn ones, or ones that just, you'll know, you get those brushes that just, they just start looking sad. And those are the ones I just give them a good conditioning and a nice thorough cleaning. And they, if you have nice quality brushes, this is the difference between a quality brush and like a hardware store brush. Hardware store brushes are great. I have a bunch of them. I use them all the time. But they don't usually have the longevity. That's been my experience because they don't clean as well. But if you take really good care of your brushes, I don't think I've ever thrown a brush away.
Now, never. Do you treat synthetic and natural the same?
So I showed you guys cleaning. The synthetic was a Klingon. This Annie Sloan brush is a natural bristle brush.
Well, I'm picking up what Leanne's putting down, which is just every letter in the alphabet. Not, it's like somebody went crazy on her keyboard.
Oh, yeah. Okay, hello. Maybe she has a kid.
But it's a two-liner.
That sounds like a kid thing.
Yeah.
So I cleaned the natural bristle I use usually for texture. So if you use texture medium like salt wash, there are certain things I try to not rinse down my sink. If it's just minimal, I'll let it go down the sink. But I also have a gravel pit outside of my house, just outside. It's a hose bib that's got a pit of gravel in it. And so if I've got things like salt wash or mud that I've used for a raised stencil, like a joint compound or anything, patina paints can be bad for your pipes because if you have metal pipes and corrosive patina paint, you want to watch that out or wash that. So there are certain things I don't rinse down my sink at all. We are on a well. And a septic system.
What?
Yeah, surprise. So, as far as natural versus synthetic, I pay more attention to what's on the brush, I think, than what type of brush it is. I use the same soaps for all of them, whether they're natural or synthetic, but whether I use something that I need to cut through oil with, or whether I just use water and a light soap for paint, that's usually what I'm paying attention to, is what am I trying to clean out of the brush? Is it oil-based or is it water-based?
Tarnia says that's how she feels at the end of the week. All the letters.
Yeah.
That's me daily.
And we're almost there. Yeah, we have 3 kids. I feel ya. So that's kind of it, you guys. That's all my brush cleaning tips. This is by far the most used area of my workspace, I would say. I spend so much time at the sink. And that's kind of why I want to pretty it up a little bit by painting these cabinets. So it's really a luxury to have, if you have a nice garage sink or a laundry sink or something, to have an area that you can just totally set up and spread out and have stuff.
Oh, that's cheating. It's Friday there because she's in Australia.
Oh, she is in Australia.
Yeah. Yeah. Demons.
Guys, Tarnia is the owner of Carts and Millie Paint. Tarnia, I finished that piece and I photographed it. It's super pretty, but now I have to edit the YouTube video. And I think it already has a home too. And then when I need to clean my sink, because I do try to keep it, oh, this is huge, you guys. When you rinse your brushes, it's not going to always rinse. You're going to get little flakes of paint. I'm going to show you guys this, and it's super gross. Okay?
You really need to clean your stuff.
It's flakes of paint, of dried paint. That's it. This is my sink strainer. Put a strainer in your sink so this stuff doesn't all go down your drain.
What is that? She's got that bottle dryer too. Your strainer, your thing over here.
Oh yeah, yeah. Pick them up there. I see them all the time at the thrift store. So if you don't have a baby, pick one up at the thrift store. I'm sure on eBay and stuff. It's made by Munchkin, which is a brand of baby stuff that Target carries. Target, yeah. I don't think Target has those anymore though. I don't think I've seen that in a while. So I like this guy. This is just a metal mesh. And I use this the most for cleaning my sink.
What are you doing?
I try to keep it clean. It's usually got dry paint all over it.
What the hey?
I'm pretty aggressive with it, but I just try to keep it from getting super crusted.
There is no violence in the workplace.
And then this does have a spray hose on it to rinse that out. So I don't worry about it getting, you know, it doesn't have to be beautiful, shiny, clean. It's a work sink, but, you know, I try to keep it from getting too bad and things from going down my drain.
Oh,
That Sean would scream at me about.
So about your sink, she says you have a really nice sink. So
this is Sean's bath towel?
Yeah. Before use.
He's only used it once.
Oh, you wait.
This is just one day of use.
Last month. It's once a month, right? So I was just going to mention the story as far as the sink, that it's just some random base that we found on Craigslist or Marketplace.
And this is much nicer. You guys, I am redoing all the faces of these. I just put primer on them, so I took them all off. I am going to show you guys the process on this, but I'm going to spray them all. So that's why my cabinet is all taken apart. It's going to look much prettier.
She looks hideous.
Yeah, it looks really bad right now. And it's got plastic up here just because I'm going to spray it. So a couple other things I keep out here. I've got Dixie cups under here. These are for pouring resin. I do have a big cleaning bucket. And sometimes, what do I use that for?
Not a whole lot. I never see that.
Yeah. I keep
it's one of those when the doors go on, like some stuff just gets forgotten.
I don't want to tear this plastic down.
I know we're not the only ones.
I've got an old pot down there, like pots and pans, like a pot. And that's what I use if I need a pot to soak hardware in with vinegar, because it's corrosive when you boil vinegar. Don't put it in your good pots and pans. But you can boil your hardware on the stove with a little bit of vinegar. So I keep a pot down here. That's, you know, that way the kids don't pull it out of the cabinet and think it's good for cooking their mac and cheese.
We're building strength here.
I use a funnel. I've got a funnel. This is a strainer. This is just a plastic one, but it's good for fast straining. It's not as fine as the paper strainers that I'll use for my sprayer.
Oh, I may have used that for cookies.
Yeah, but those are a couple things. Rubber gloves. These are the chemical cleaning rubber gloves, but I'll use these if I'm cleaning, like if I put stripper on something so I don't get stripper on my hands.
I need to make a doctor's appointment.
I think what random stuff I have out here. So that's the kind of stuff that's around my cleaning station. All right, you guys, I hope that was somewhat helpful. That's a lot of information.
I think everybody started to fall asleep.
Yeah, no, seriously, by far, right? This is the most frequent thing we do. I will spend sometimes an hour just sitting here washing brushes.
Oh, moonshine fits nice in there too.
Moonshine? In what?
In your cabin. Moonshine. Oh, no. Never mind. Sherry, she said moonshine fits well. Never mind.
Oh.
Moonshine. Okay, not like a product.
Oh, okay. I was like, what's moonshine?
Yeah.
Like, I get you. I feel you, Sherry.
Baby steps. Baby steps.
I know
steps.
What you're talking about. Or Kentucky was Kentucky bourbon. Kentucky whiskey. So anyway, and then I've got, you know, extra Bad Ace brush soap down there. This is my sponges are in here that I'll use for clear coat. I've got a magic eraser, a pair of scissors for cutting this cording that I'll use to hang my brushes up. So I don't know. We just got to go through my drawers on camera. It's like a dream come true. I know. Sean disagrees. All right, guys.
This is awkward.
I'm going to pop off. My brushes are clean. I'm not doing any more tonight. My nails look good. All right, you guys.
You just give me the finger?
No, I give you all the fingers.
Oh.
Yeah, that's okay. It's not offensive that way. I'm going to pop off. You guys have a really good weekend. Stay safe. Halloween is coming up. Go get your costumes ready. And I will catch you guys next Thursday. I do have a YouTube video coming up. It's actually going to be my video with Tarnia's piece from Carts and Millie Paint. Came out really, really, really pretty. I'm thrilled with the piece. So I'll get that out to you guys this next week. So check out my YouTube channel, Brush by Brandy, on YouTube for a tutorial that I do each week for you guys. All right. Have a good weekend.